Having a great intro for your videos isn't something mandatory and will not make a bad video any better. What it can bring to your channel though is extra character and branding, and that is very important. I am Cole, and in this video, we're going to review the mIntro2 DV pack by MotionVFX. Let's get started. Those of you familiar with our channel know that we love to inspire and share with you tools and techniques to help developing your skills. We also wouldn't promote a product on our channel if we didn't believe that it can be valuable to our audience. And while ultimately nothing beats a 100% original creation, not everyone is a born designer, can or is willing to spend hours, days or more building their own effects. And some of the templates that we're going to review today could help you build a great intro and more within minutes. Full disclosure, so it doesn't get in the way, this is not a sponsored video. What we did is partner with them to give our audience a discount on MotionVFX catalog. And our affiliate link inside the description will help support the channel if you use it to make a purchase. Stick with us until the end of the video to learn more about this. But as this is first and foremost a review, I will tell you what we liked about this plugin, if it's worth it, and what we think could be improved. The first feature that we liked is the mInstaller. This is MotionVFX Product Manager that you will use to install, repair, or remove any of the products that you purchased. And with the amount of assets that you're getting in this kind of plugins, this is a welcome feature. I have here a list of all the products that are linked to our account and can install any of them with a click on the install button. Once installed, we can open DaVinci Resolve and inside the effects library in Toolbox, Titles, MotionVFX, mIntro2, we'll find all the assets that are in the pack. But in the case that you have more than one product installed, you can also use the search feature and tap, for example, mIntro to filter out all the assets. That's a quick and easy way to find exactly what you want. Now look at that list. There is 30 pre-built intro that will get you started super fast. There is also 20 add-ons and animated background that will help you build or extend your own custom intro. And at the very end, you'll find 5 title templates that, to be honest, are okay, but are not of the same quality or even quantity than the rest of the pack. All those templates are very customizable, and while I won't go over every each of them because there is a lot, I am going to show you a selection of our favorites for which we had to design some very random logo. Let's watch. What do you think? Pretty cool, right? Now, templates are great, but usually you need to bring in your own logo. But maybe you don't have one yet, or you don't want one, and that's not an issue. Because every intro template that you have in this pack has an option for a text instead of the logo. Let's test this with the intro number 4. I'm going to add a template to the timeline, and we're going to play it through so you can have a look. The whole pack is built around a similar structure, so you'll find for every template several custom panels full of controls. There is definitely a lot of options, but I wish they would add a few built-in presets just to speed up and help finding a good starting point. To switch to text, I can just click on this button and open the text control panel to type my text here. So we're gonna type retro nerd. Okay, I'm going to select a nice font. Scale up, for example, to 225, space down, gonna make it connect. In the elements control, I can change the dot color, for example, to fun blue, and zaps, where are my zaps? Here, to pink. To see what I'm talking about is, there you go, here are the zaps, could have something a bit more intense. Okay, pretty cool. And now for the fun part, we can open the content controls, as this is where you're gonna find all the controls to tune up all the various effects. I'm going to check how far the zaps are going. So I'm going to raise slightly the content scale. Okay, not too much. And I am going to raise the ever so popular chromatic aberration with this slider. That's really cool. That gives a nice retro effect. That's pretty cool, but we can go even further by adding some keyframes to animate one of those effects. For example, the chromatic aberration. And if you find that keyframing Fusion templates inside the edit page is still a bit buggy, there's a simple solution and you just need to click on that little magic wand to open it inside Fusion where you have full control. So here, if I select the intro pack, I'm gonna pass as a single viewer so it can be easier. So what we like is that text is revealed with a strong chromatic aberration and it is reduced around here. Okay, so I'm gonna add a keyframe, go back a little, and here, add another keyframe. Okay, I'm going to set the chroma aberration to default. I'm going to open the keyframe editor, and inside the chromatic aberration control, I can just select my two frames, type Shift S, and this is going to smooth a little the in and out point of the animation. We're going to have a quick fade out on the effect. That seems to be pretty nice. Let's go back to the edit page and play through. Really cool. That was not only really cool, it was super quick and easy to build. And if I decide to change for a logo, I can do that very easily. Click on the logo button, open the logo control panel, browse, set our logo. Gonna scale it up, make it a lot larger. Not that much cool. Okay, gonna position it. Perfect. And now, if I play it through, just with a few clicks, I swapped to a logo and I kept the same effects and I was really neat. Now this is just using the pre-built intros and with a bit more work, you could really create something totally unique. Particularly if you start playing with all the add-ons and animated backgrounds that you'll find inside this plugin. And those are not even limited to just intros and you could use them for chapter transitions and so much more. To be honest, we did not fall in love with every each of them because it is a matter of taste. But with that level of quality and the amount of options, you should find yourself a good fit. So what are your thoughts on this kind of plugin? Well, quality professional products are not particularly cheap, and for good reasons. But time is money. So if you are looking to quickly add a slick intro and more effects to your videos with just a few clicks, it might definitely be worth it. There's 50 plus templates, they are very customizable and easy to use. In our opinion, the MotionVFX team did a really good job on this pack. And as we said previously, the only thing that we would like them to add to this pack is built-in presets for every template. While that and maybe a better selection of titles, but that's just my opinion. MotionVFX has a large catalog of really great plugins, so if you'd like to treat yourself with some of their products, you can use the link in the description with the code CORENBLUE to get yourself 15% discount on everything, except bundles. We hope that you enjoyed this video and at the very least, you got inspired to build yourself a new intro. Give it a like and we'll see you in the next video. See ya.